Namaste. I am back with more stories from Sharada Ma's life, and let's discuss what we can learn from these incidents from her life. After Sri Ramakrishna's Mahasamadhi, Sharada Ma went on a pilgrimage. She was in the train on the way to Vrindavan. She was wearing a gold amulet like a bangle on her arm, and she was lying down on the train with her arm on the windowsill, and everybody could see her amulet. Suddenly, Sri Ramakrishna appeared in front of her and said, "Why are you wearing that amulet in that way? A thief can easily snatch that." She immediately got up, removed the amulet and put it inside a small tin trunk where she had also kept a picture of Sri Ramakrishna. She realized that Sri Ramakrishna was always protecting her. What did I learn from this story? We all hear our inner voice telling us to do something or to not do something. It is very important for us to listen to that inner voice. The God residing in each one of us knows what is best for us, and that God always speaks and guides us. We just have to listen. While in Vrindavan, Sharada Ma and Golap Ma and their companions were in the temple of Madhavji. A child had soiled the floor, and the devotees and all the people who were inside the temple were just looking at each other and talking. "Oh, look at that. Somebody's child has done that. I wonder where the mother is. Why can't she come and clean it? This is a temple. Don't they know how to keep a temple clean?" They were all talking. But Golap Ma saw this. She immediately tore a piece of cloth from her clothes and she quickly went and cleaned the place. And then now the crowd is saying, "Oh, it must be her child. Look at the way she has not brought up her child well. Why didn't she clean it before?" And then somebody else said, "I don't think it is her child who did that. I think she is one of those saintly women who just came and cleaned it up." What is there in this story? When we see something disturbing, it is best for us to find out how we can help and do that task immediately without waiting for instruction. Another learning is, when we associate ourselves with saintly people, people who have humane qualities, people with compassion, and people who have the love for God and who always keep God in their minds, we also slowly imbibe their qualities. And slowly our life also changes. We become more useful to society. In this instance, there was no use in discussing whose child did this, why that child did this. Point was, the floor was soiled and it just needed to be cleaned. And that's exactly what Golap Ma did. This is very, very important. That is the behavior that we need to aspire for. How can I be useful to society? Think about that. In 1889, Sharada Ma went to Puri. She stayed at the Kshetrabhai Mutt for 2 months. Every morning and in the evening, she would go to have the darshan of Lord Jagannath. And whenever she went, she would carry a photograph of Sri Ramakrishna, and it would be kept inside the folds of her sari. And when she went in for darshan, she would open the fold. She uncovered it before the deities during darshan time. Sri Ramakrishna's photograph was inside the fold of her sari. Sharada Ma believed that a picture or photograph is the same as the person in the photograph. The incident in Sharada Ma's life and her behavior is very important for us, because at this moment we are not able to visit holy places or temples and shrines to offer our prayers. The corona pandemic and the lockdown imposed by the government has made it impossible for us to go anywhere, and we have to follow government instructions. In that case, how do we pray? we can develop an attitude of prayer as soon as we see an image or a picture or a photograph of God. Her approach, Sharadamma's approach to divinity, was all-pervading. And you all have heard about the story of Swami Vivekananda and the King Mangal Singh. Ruchira ji described that story just a few days ago. Mangal Singh was English educated and did not believe in idol worship. Swami Vivekananda wanted to explain to him, so he asked his minister to spit on the photograph of Mangal Singh's father, and the Diwan refused. And so Swami Vivekananda said, "Look, it is not your father, but your minister has refused to spit on that photograph. And why is that? That is because that photograph reminds him of your father, for whom he has deep respect and reverence." It is exactly the same thing when it comes to worshipping gods in the form of idols. It was March 1890, and Sharadamma remembered that Sri Ramakrishna was not able to offer Pindadanam for his mother. She went to do it on his behalf at the feet of Vishnu in Gaya. After the rituals, Sharadamma went to Bodh Gaya, where Lord Buddha had attained enlightenment. And when she went there, she saw a beautiful big monastery with all facilities for the monks. Her heart was sad and she prayed, "My children don't even have a roof over their heads and they don't even know whether they're going to get the next meal. They are roaming around begging for food. Oh God, I just pray my children also have a monastery like this." And in 8 years' time, that wish was fulfilled. What do we learn from this episode? Sharadamma's prayers have many layers. Her love and compassion and concern for her children is, of course, obvious. But at the next level, her prayer was unselfish. She asked for others. Ever so often, we are in situations where we can't help anyone, but we can certainly offer prayers. And sincere prayers for the welfare of others is always fulfilled. Soon after Belur Math was built, there was an outbreak of plague. Swami Vivekananda got ready to do some service and start the relief work for the plague. But he realized there was no money. So he thought, maybe we should sell this land that we have purchased to build the mutt. We are all monks, we can live under the trees. And Swami Shivananda said to him, "You know, for all major decisions, you do ask our holy mother Sharadamma for her opinion and approval. I think we should ask her this time also." So they went, and when Sharadamma heard this proposal, she outright refused. Swami Vivekananda was shocked, because Sharadamma has always supported his ideas and projects, but this time she said no, and she gave her reasons. She said, "You cannot sell the mutt property. It belongs to the master and not just to you. Of course, you, my children, are all heroic sons and you can live under the trees. But what about future generations? Selling the mutt and doing one relief activity, with that, does the activity of the mutt end? Is this what the master wanted? No. There are multiple activities that you all have to get involved with. Selling the mutt is not an option." Swami Vivekananda understood, and the mutt was not sold. This episode is very, very important for all of us. We need to think about the consequences of every action. Emotional responses must be weighed against common sense and logic. We are all trustees of whatever we get in this life, and we must do our best to preserve and protect it
for the future. If we go deeper into Sharadamma's advice, we understand that this is true of everything. Let's look at natural resources. We are all trustees for what we have now. The air, the water, the soil, the birds, the animals, the trees. We need to protect it for future generations. And the same holds good for material things. Another very, very important learning from this episode is, it also means that we are all mere instruments in the hands of gods, and we need to live up to that expectation from God. And how do we do that? With appropriate behavior and preserving whatever is given to us. There was a robber and a dacoit who was very devoted to Sharadamma. He had great respect for her. And his whole life changed ever since he met her. He would often bring her fruits. And Sharadamma would tell him, please eat and go. But the women of the family, they would just throw the food at him. After all, he was a robber. Why bother? And Sharadamma was very angry at such behavior. She reprimanded them and she said, he is as dear to me as Swami Sharadananda, Sharad, is. So you cannot behave like this. Treat him with respect. And she would go and serve him herself. Now this is very important. We need to learn to treat everybody with respect. And we also need to understand that people can change. Bad behaviors can be replaced with good behavior. And when somebody undergoes that change, we need to support that person, encourage that person, and also treat that person with a lot of respect. There is another interesting incident about Swami Sri Ramakrishna's nephew, Shibuda. He once told Sharadamma, oh, I'm going to come and stay here for 3 days. And she said, yeah, but how is that possible? If you come here and stay for 3 days, who is going to do the worship in the temple? And Shibuda said, oh, that's okay. I have finished the worship for all 3 days. I just did it all today. And I finished it. It's okay. I'll stay here for 3 days. Sharadamma said, no, that's not how it works. No. You need to worship every day and you need to make offerings every day. She stressed the importance of discipline and regularity. You have to be regular with your activities. Just like we eat every day, prayer and worship and time spent thinking about God must also be daily activities. There's another incident about what happened when Sharadamma actually visited Chennai, Madras. She met a lady who knew only Tamil and Sharadamma knew only Bengali. But guess what? Both the women had a lovely conversation, lots of laughter, and they conversed with each other for over 1 hour. Now, how is that possible? It is possible. And that's what we need to learn and understand from that little interaction. We can communicate with anyone as long as there is a connection. And how do we establish the connection? The world over, we are all the same. We have similar emotions, we have similar thoughts, we have similar feelings, and we all have similar relationships. It's very important for all of us to live by the creed, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the whole world is my own family. What did you learn from all these incidents from Sharadamma's life? Think about it. Think about how you can practice all these learnings and become a better version of yourself. I am slowly becoming a better Varsha. How about you? Namaste.